Bert from Makers Making Change. Welcome to the Makers Making Change LipSync Firmware Upload and Calibration Tutorial. Today we're going to go through the step-by-step process of calibrating the LipSync. Congratulations on building a LipSync. Now let's calibrate it so it can be ready to use.
Following the manual you used to assemble the LipSync, go to Part 8, Setting Up the Device. If you're working on the LipSync, LipSync Wireless, or LipSync Macro, follow steps A to C. If you're building LipSync Gaming, skip these steps and head right to the setup guide found on GitHub. Step A is about uploading the microcontroller code, which will tell the LipSync what to do. Firstly, we're going to download the latest version of Arduino IDE, which can be found through the link in this manual, or through the link below the video. Next, we're going to follow the link depending on the version of the LipSync you're building. Once you're there, right-click, Save As, then change the file extension from a .txt to a .ino, and save it to your desktop. The next step is to open up the Arduino IDE. If you get this message, just say OK. Then go to Tools, Board, and either select Arduino or Genuino Micro. Connect the USB cable from the LipSync to your computer, and make sure to wait 3 seconds before touching the mouthpiece while it's initializing, or it may interfere with the calibration. Next, select Tools, then Port, and select the port that the USB is connected to. It should say Arduino or Genuino beside it. Next, look at the top left corner of the Arduino IDE, and you'll see a button with a right arrow. Click that to start uploading the microcontroller code to the LipSync device. The Arduino IDE will search your computer for the .ino file we just downloaded. A message at the bottom left will say done uploading or upload successful. If you encounter an upload error, unplug and reinsert the USB to make sure the correct board and port options are selected.
Now that we're done uploading the code, we can start physically calibrating the LipSync.
Press and hold the two buttons at the back of the LipSync to initiate the calibration process.
If it doesn't start blinking, there might be an issue with the code. Repeat steps 2 to 7 and resave and upload the code, ensuring that it's a .ino file. The LED should slowly blink red and green 5 times. Wait 3 seconds and it should flash green 6 times.
So, pressing the buttons, wait for it to flash. Up first. And to the right. Then down. Then to the left. And you'll know it's done when it starts flashing. Now, if you're using the original LipSync, you should be able to move your cursor using the mouthpiece. If you can, congratulations! You've successfully assembled and calibrated your LipSync. If you're using the LipSync Wireless, go to your computer's Bluetooth settings. Turn your Bluetooth on, and if you can't discover the LipSync, add Bluetooth or other device. If it's not named LipSync, it might be the device with the keyboard icon beside it, under a different name. Try it and see if it works. If you're trying to use the LipSync Wireless on a mobile device, follow the same steps. If you're using an iPad or iPhone, ensure your device is running iOS 13 or higher. For more information on device compatibility in the various LipSync versions, check out the user and setup guides, which can be found on GitHub.
Remember to always wait 3 seconds after plugging the LipSync into a new device to let it initialize. Thank you for watching the LipSync calibration video. I hope it was helpful. For more information on the LipSync and other cool assistive devices you can make, head over to www.makersmakingchange.com.